Coming up on One Fighting Championship, Kings and Champions. In the flyweight division, a rising Malaysian MMA prospect, Chun Yun Ting, against Ronald Lau, seven-time Muay Thai champion from Singapore. Next, in the light heavyweight division, Saipan's number one ranked light heavyweight, Swain the Pain Kango, squares off against Jake Butler, NCAA Division I wrestler from the United States of America. Finally, for the ONE FC Lightweight World Championship belt, the challenger, a dream lightweight champion and Japanese MMA superstar, Shinya Tobikan Judan Aoki, squares off against the reigning and defending ONE FC Lightweight World Champion, Kotetsu No Face Boku.
Welcome along, everyone, to ONE FC Kings and Champions right here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium. And tonight, the main event is Kotetsu Boku, the champion in the lightweight division, against his compatriot, Jason, Shinya Aoki.
This is a very interesting stylistic matchup. Boku, a very heavy-handed former K-1 and Shudo veteran, looks to come in and put the leather on like he did with Zoro Babel Moreau. Aoki, if you know mixed martial arts, you know that he wants to get this to the ground and get the submission. Who can impose their will? I don't know, but we'll find out.
Plenty of great action ahead. Let's see what's coming up.
ONE Fighting Championship uses the global MMA rule set that blends the best practices of Asian and international rules. Each bout will consist of 3 5-minute rounds with a minute break in between rounds. Championship bouts will consist of 5 5-minute rounds. A victory is attained by one of the following ways: decision, knockout, submission, verbal or physical tap out, technical knockout, referee or corner stoppage. In the event that a bout goes to a decision, the winner will be judged based on the following criteria in descending order of importance: near knockout or submission, damage inflicted, striking combinations and cage generalship, takedowns or takedown defense, aggression.
First contest of the evening in the flyweight division, the age-old battle between Malaysia and Singapore. It's Chun Yun Ting against Ronald Lau. This then, a flyweight contest. Just 1 year the difference between them. Ronald Lau is the older man. He's also 6 centimeters taller. This one is Malaysia against Singapore.
Good evening, Singapore, and welcome to our very first fight of the night. This fight is brought to you by Nature's Glory, the name you trust for health. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, standing at 170 centimeters tall and weighing in at 56.7 kilograms, making his professional MMA debut, fighting out of Muay Fit, a rising Malaysian MMA prospect. Give it up for Chun Yun Ting! And introducing to you his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, standing at 176 centimeters tall and weighing in at 56.7 kilograms with a professional record of 1 win, no losses. Fighting out of Fight G, it is 7-time Muay Thai champion from Singapore, it's Ronald Lau! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, referee Kenichi Serizawa.
Yeah, sit down, come on. Come here. Sirloin, Sirloin. Okay. No head button, no groin, no spine, okay? No hook cage, okay? Okay, first, check out. Okay, back.
Such an amiable looking fella, isn't he, Ronald Lowe? Doesn't look as if he's come to fight, but with this crowd behind him, he'll certainly be encouraged to do just that. This is when it all starts for him. In the green, white, and black trunks. Against Chen in the predominantly white shorts. This fight is brought to you by Nature's Glory, the name you trust for health.
Nice low kick, putting together good combinations right away, just like I thought Lowe would. I like how he took the center of the cage right away and he's setting the pace. Misses there with the high kick, but so far Lowe's doing a good job of mixing up the hands and the feet, and it doesn't look like Ting is really able to get a range here. He's really flat-footed.
Very upright, Ronald Lowe. He's not upright anymore. Pressed against the cage wall there, managed to roll himself out of that. To the applause of the crowd here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium in Kallang, just east of center of Singapore.
Jab.
Ronald Lowe's corner men telling him to box and to jab. Look at that upright style he's got. The head is way up there, the chin not really tucked in at all. Doesn't stop him getting off a left and right though. And again, takes a jab there from Chen.
Angles and boxing. Angles and boxing, Ronald.
A little bit scrappy. Can see the determination on Chen's face. A Malaysian in Singapore.
Nice right hand down the pipe by Lowe. Another
and
nice
a left.
Right.
Oh, and a left right as well from Ronald Lowe.
Lowe's exploiting that reach well. He's got a couple of nice marks now in Tin's face. He's punching with his head really high in the air, which is a little bit awkward, but he is being able to find the target each time.
I'm wondering if Ronald Lowe's nose might be leaking a little bit of blood. He took a right hand there.
Nice right kick and right over the top.
Yeah, it does seem to be bleeding slightly. Singaporean's nose, but it doesn't stop him coming forward. Oh, and he took a straight right. And it shook him and knocked him down, and now a bit of ground and pound. The referee standing right over them. And he's dabbing at that nose again. It's clearly bothering him, the Singaporean.
Ting's in half guard, now he's gonna wanna try to either posture up and create some space to pass. Or sit up, get some space to throw some punches there. Looks like he's gonna start to pass his right knee outside of guard.
Underhook.
Lowe needs to start working back on using his right hand instead of holding Ting down. He needs to start pushing and recomposing guard or using that space when he sits up to get back to his feet.
3 minutes of this first round gone. There's another two to go. 5 minute rounds here at 1FC. This is a three round contest.
Working the pass. Nice pass by Ting. Oh, just missed with the knee.
But he's dabbing at that nose again, Jason. It's clearly bothering him.
Keeps catching that leg, but you got to be careful reaching for it.
I suspect that nose might be broken. It's clearly causing him lots of trouble there. He dabs again, and he's taking lefts and rights, and another right, and the Singaporean is looking quite exposed here. He's done some good work, but he's clearly uncomfortable and now taking a battering with the knees as well. A right hand comes in from Chen. The Malaysian's on top here.
Ting is trying to get in there and finish the fight there. His corner's imploring him.
I think the referee may step in. There it is. There came a point where Ronald Lowe was just not defending himself anymore. So bothered was he by the injuries to his face. And it's the Malaysian who comes to Singapore and conquers. And look how happy his corner men are. I fancy there's a few tears there. Chen Yung Ting, it's an emotional victory for him. The blood on his face and on his chest is from his opponent.
He turned that fight around, didn't he? From the beginning, it looked like he was just getting dotted up, and Lowe really connected with the right hands. It was probably about 70-30 on the punches, and then that one takedown really started to switch the momentum in a team's favor.
You can see the emotion, though, Jason, the contest between Singapore and Malaysia tend to develop. And he goes over to his opponent now to make sure he's okay, and he'll be fine. Let's just take a look at this, Jason.
One of the times here we had the takedown, a couple of nice short right that put him on his butt, and then just keeping really good pressure on top ever since he was in the top there, and then that right hand right up the center and behind the ear, a couple of nice punches there, and instead of being able to move out of the way for Lowe, referee stops the fight, gives Ting his first victory here in the professional rankings.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Kenichi Serizawa calls a halt to this bout at 3 minutes 58 seconds of the very first round for your winner via referee stoppage due to strikes. Fighting out of the blue corner, Chin Yun Ting!
Swain Kanko versus Jake Butler when we return.
Against Jake Butler. You will have seen Jake Butler when One Fighting Championship was last in Kuala Lumpur. He's 30 years old, 5 years older than Kongo, and 20 centimeters taller.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next fight is 3 rounds of 5 minutes in the 1FC light heavyweight division. And this fight is brought to you by Clear Vision. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, standing at 170 centimeters tall and weighing in at 93 kilograms, holding a professional record of 5 wins and 1 loss. Fighting out of MCA MMA, Saipan's ranked number 1 light heavyweight, it's Swain the Pain Kanko! And introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, standing at 190 centimeters tall and weighing in at 93.1 kilograms, holding a professional record of 1 win, no losses, fighting out of Evolve MMA, an NCAA Division I wrestler from the United States of America. Please welcome Jake Butler! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, referee Yuji Shimada.
Okay, fighters coming. Okay, no headbutts, no other growing, non-stop stomp the face, okay? Anytime, obey my command, okay? Touch gloves.
Here we go then, and that is the very beautiful Christine Hawa, a new ring card girl here at 1FC, and it's great to have her on board. This is Jake Butler. And it's great to have him on board as well. What great condition he appears to be in.
It's going to be interesting to see if Jake wants to test his stand-up here and feel out if he can use some of that reach or not.
This fight is brought to you by Clear Vision, the official eye care partner of 1FC.
You know, obviously having that NCAA Division I wrestling experience, he's very, very comfortable. Oh, nice head kick!
Wow!
I got my answer.
You heard the noise, I'm sure.
Beautiful head kick. Well, he's using that reach well, which I think is what he needs to do here. His corner's yelling strike.
And he takes him down.
Nice trip. Now we get to see Butler work out of guard here and see how comfortable he is.
This is where he's been schooled over the past few weeks at Evolve. But it could be where he's a little exposed against this man.
Get to see what kind of grappling work Swain has here on his back. He needs to close his guard or start working his legs up and kick off Butler, because he's going to get a lot of leverage and a really solid base with those punches.
The right hand's caught up, the left hand comes down. Few of them, very few of those were a clean connection, I must say.
You know, if you've never trained in mixed martial arts or BJJ, it's really hard to appreciate how immovable the base is of guys that have really solid wrestling. You know, you feel like you can just push them off or move, but a guy that has that solid wrestling credential feels twice as heavy as he really is. Oh. When you've got a guy like Jake who's just a beast.
Jake just cuffed him with a good left hand
there. Working out a front guillotine. He may be too tall to me from this position.
It was noticeable when they were boxing in the early seconds that Jake actually really brought himself much lower down, in a way negating that height. But the height difference could, as you imply, sometimes work against Jake here.
Oh, beautiful takedown by Jake. Lots of wrestlers like Dan Henderson, Randy Couture, Keith Haring have made successful martial arts careers having that solid, solid wrestling base. This is a position Matt Hughes likes to use a lot at Crucifix, where you trap the leg underneath your, I'm sorry, the arm underneath your leg, and he's gonna try to trap his other arm across there, and if he sits towards his head, he's gonna get a lot of room to punch.
Kongo keeping him at close quarters, though, until he finds that distance and therefore the leverage to bring down.
This is going to be the beginning of the end.
Here come the rights, and Yuji Shimada knew that he couldn't let that one go on any longer. Once he generated that space between him and his opponent, the leverage was there, wasn't it?
Well, I think Jake just really just looked in a different class as an athlete in this fight. I mean, he was dominated everywhere. Opened with a nice head kick, was able to close the distance, get the takedowns, move position well, and stayed busy the whole time. So I think that 30 years old, Jake still has several years of being highly competitive, and it's going to be great to watch him grow here in 1FC.
Well, he's breathing hard, and you can't blame him. That was a bit of a workout for him on the mat there.
There's that head kick. It just grazed the top of his head, but enough to knock Swain off his base a little bit. And then Jake, relentless with his ground and pound, in the beginning of the end here when he moved into mount. Just solid punches right through.
Here's Anthony Suntai.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yuji Shimada calls a hold to this bout at 2 minutes 52 seconds of the very first round. For your winner, via tap out, from the red corner, Jake Butler!
The 1FC Lightweight World Championship. The champion, Kotetsu Boku, against the challenger, his compatriot, Shinya Aoki. Years older, Boku, 5 centimeters shorter. This is Japan against Japan.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a 1FC Lightweight World Championship bout everyone has been waiting for. And it's brought to you by Sony Make Believe. Our three judges scoring this fight at cage side are Willie Carlos from the Philippines, Jason Quick from Singapore, and Joey Lipiden from the Philippines. And now, let's witness a battle for the 1FC Lightweight World Championship. This bout is 5 rounds of 5 minutes. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a BJJ fighter, standing at 180 centimeters tall and weighing in at 70.3 kilograms, holding a professional record of 32 wins, 6 losses, and 1 no contest. Fighting out of Evolve MMA in Singapore, ladies and gentlemen, he is the dream lightweight champion from Japan, Shinya Tobikanjutan Aoki! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, this man stands at 175 centimeters tall and weighs in at 70.3 kilograms, holding a professional record of 20 wins, 7 losses, and 2 draws. Fighting out of Crazy B from Japan, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending 1FC lightweight champion, Kotetsu No Face Boku! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, referee Yuji Shimada.
The champion has never fought more than 5 rounds. Despite his 28 fights, Aoki has. This is a 5-round contest. Championship fight. 5 5-minute rounds.
Boku's got a very awkward stance and style.
Very open with his hands, isn't he?
He is. You know, he throws a lot of punches from his hips, but he knew that Aoki was going to go for the takedown right away.
He didn't want that.
Well, but there's nobody better as far as being effective at submissions than Aoki, and he's doing the right thing. That he's going for that submission attempt, he's going for that takedown right away while Boku's still dry, and that sweat isn't a big factor. Already working on the back control. Softening him up with some punches. Boku has to be very careful here.
And this is not where he wanted to be. Standing up with fists flying is where Boku wanted to be.
See, Aoki's doing a good job. He's picking his shots, but he's also looking to see how Boku's going to respond to see if that'll open up the choke. That's more of a neck crank, but that still could be painful across the jaw. And Boku's doing the right thing, peeling the hand down.
Good strength from Boku.
He defended that the right way, even though that choke wasn't across the throat. That turns into more of a neck crank, but it's still very painful. Hard to see from this angle if what Aoki's working on here, but it looks like he's setting up a darce. Well, that looks like it's in pretty deep, too. This is in deep. This could be the end of it here. That's tight. I don't know if Boku's going to be able to defend it. Boku might need to. I was just going to say walk up.
Climbing up on the cage.
But that just actually gave Aoki a little more room.
And the knee to the head.
You know, the thing is, if you miss the choke here, it still causes a lot of lactic acid buildup in your arm. So if you're Aoki and you waste a lot of energy with a choke that you think is in, but it isn't, it still can be very difficult.
As if things weren't bad enough for Boku, he's taking a couple of heavy, heavy knees to that bald head of his.
Let's see if we can see from this angle here, if it's in a little bit deeper. That looks really deep. You can see it on Boku's face. If we could get around a little more here, it's really tight. Very few people as effective in the submission game as Shinya Aoki.
Knee to the face that time.
I go up to finish.
Boku survived. And he's going to try to stand back up here and fight for that wrist control.
3 minutes of this contest gone. It's almost been entirely Boku under pressure on the ground. So far, his submission defense has stood tall.
Boku has been in these positions before, maybe not with someone who's as seasoned on the ground as Shinya Aoki, but he's had 30 fights, won, I believe, 6 of his last 7 fights. He's very tough. Zorro Babel Moreira couldn't submit him, and he's a world champion in jiu-jitsu and arguably several kilos bigger than Shinya Aoki is.
So much of that fight, though, was on the feet, which is where Boku wanted it to be. And so little of this one has been. Forearms coming down on Boku's face. Almost all of this contest has taken place in that little edge of the cage. Backhand fist punching upwards there from Boku in Shinya's face. And as you say, Jason, holding these kinds of positions for 5 minutes, the old lactic acid starts to pile up. And when you're working in on just those, as tired.
Yeah, when you're working in on those chokes, it does. Oh, nice position into mount. Boku has to be very careful here, protect his arms.
He's looking for the arm.
That's going to be now, tight. I don't know if he has the extension on it. The angle looks a little bit off here.
Off, yeah. Wow. I think the release of tension around the cage as that bell went.
ONE FC will be right back with more MMA action. Don't go anywhere.
Second round of this World Championship contest, scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds.
Round 2.
What a grueling first 5 minutes we had. Now, Boku is back where he'd rather be. How long will that last? On his feet, with the potential to throw punches. This fight brought to you by Sony, make believe.
Aoki's playing a smart game. He's not going to get engaged in a stand-up war with Boku. He's going right for the takedown, taking this where he's the best and most efficient. It's one thing I think a lot of people thought that Zorro maybe did wrong was tried to get out of his comfort zone and stood a little too long. Had a lot of success with the punches and the kicks, but not playing to the strong suit as well as he could have. Aoki's not making that mistake. He's taking Boku out of his element, getting to the ground right away and keeping solid pressure on.
Took him all of 30 seconds to get Boku out of his element, as it did in the first round. Could be another grueling 4.5 minutes.
You see Aoki's left foot there that's pressing on the thigh of Boku. He's using that foot. That's going to be a springboard for him to pass guard here in a second. He's going to use that leg, push off, and pass into either mount or guard like that. Still passing, driving that knee through, turning the hips. And Aoki has a judo background also, so a lot of base, a lot of good positioning.
He's a judo black belt and a BJJ black belt. Boku just covering up for all he's worth, taking punishment to the back of the head, around the ears, and there,
oh, that's
the RNC.
Deep. That's underneath his chin. This is very deep. This could be it.
Tapping
We've got
out.
A new
he's
champion,
done it.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Aoki has got his revenge. Evolve have got their revenge.
For your winner, by submission, via rear naked choke, and you, ONE FC lightweight world champion from the red corner, Shinya Tobikanjudan Aoki.
Okay.
So an enthralling fight, and in the end, it was grappling, overcoming the power of the punch.
You know, I think Aoki did exactly what he needed to do. He didn't stand and trade with Boku. He played a very smart, specific game plan. He got Boku to the ground safely, methodically, worked to the back, and got the rear naked choke in. And you know what? Boku's going to fight another day, and Aoki is going to defend the belt another day.
Yeah, that belt is safely now around the waist of Shinya Aoki, but plenty more to come in 1FC's future. We'll see you next time.